Italian Prime Minister Paolo Gentiloni is scaling up the fight on people traffickers in the Mediterranean. He plans to transfer some of the country's troops stationed in Iraq to Niger to help combat the trafficking of desperate migrants.
Italy has been pushing against the inflow of migrants arriving on Europe's shores. Some of its ships have been used in the European Union's Operation Sophia to help Libya's coast guard curb migrant flows. The government now wants military forces transferred from Iraq to Niger.
We have to continue to work, concentrating our attention and energies on the mixed threat of human trafficking and terrorism, which has been consolidating over the years in the Sahel region in Africa. For this reason, part of our forces engaged in Iraq will be deployed to Niger in the coming months. This is a proposal the government will make to Parliament in a mission aiming to consolidate the country and defeating human trafficking and terrorism. That is what Italian soldiers are doing in the world.
It's not yet known how many troops will be sent to Niger, but a French newspaper had put it at least 470 as part of a commitment made to French President Emmanuel Macron. The Italian parliament is expected to be formally dissolved by the end of this year ahead of March elections. It will continue to meet for ordinary administration and could approve Gentiloni's request for the transfer of military personnel. Wazir Khamsin, CGTN.
Well, to discuss this further, we're joined live from Egypt, General Samir Raghib. He is the chairman at the Arab Center for Strategic Studies. Thank you very much for joining us, General Samir. How will this move by Italy to shift troops from Iraq to Niger help in the war on terrorism and smuggling in the region?
Italy and the European Union strategy not fighting terrorism in Libya. The matter is converting Libya as a buffer zone for migrants and convert this phenomena over the shoulder of Libyan people and Libyan country. Because if they want to fight terrorism, must push all parties in Libya for settlement to have a unified political authority, a unified army that capable to fight terrorism in all over Libya. The matter of Italy and the European Union to convert Libya as a refugee city for collecting refugees that refused their asylum in European generally and Italia particularly to be a permanent refuge for migrants from all over sub-Saharan countries, even from outside Libya. There is no irregular migrants from Libyans. The irregular migration came from sub-Saharan and Sahel and Sahara countries. The existence of foreign troops in the Libyan territories or in Niger territories will increase the phenomenon of terrorism that will attract terrorists from all over Africa to combat against the foreign troops, particularly Italy, that is an old colonial for Libya, that pushed the nationalist people to struggle against the Italian persistence over the Libyan territories. The motivation is the interest, the economic interest in Libya, the influence interest in Libya. Also, not all the European Union countries concerned with Libya has the same agenda. France has its own agenda, Italy has its own agenda, Britain, Germany. So without a unified United Nations umbrella for intervention in settling the situation in Libya, that will exacerbate the situation in Libya and will convert Libya to the next step for ISIS after defeating ISIS in Iraq and Syria.
Okay, thank you very much for your analysis. That was General Samir Raqeb. He is the chairman of the Arab Center for Strategic Studies.